Hi, it has been so long. Welcome back to my channel. I literally have not posted on YouTube in like almost a year, I think, and all of my old videos are like privated and it's like I never existed on YouTube except for I did. There are like 250 subscribers that I have just left you guys hanging. I'm so sorry. Thank you for not unsubscribing, even though I haven't posted in so long. But today we're gonna catch up. We're gonna catch up about everything in my life. I have so many things to share with you guys. This video probably won't be very long, but do be expecting more content to be posted from me. I did a live on Instagram literally last night, or no, it wasn't live, I posted on my stories, and literally so many people swiped up and was like, where have you been? Why isn't this on your YouTube? Just like interact with me, and it made me miss this so much, so here I am. I'm back. I don't know what I'm gonna post. I don't know what kind of videos I'm gonna do. I like live a completely different life now, but I'm just excited. I'm trying to make this work without a MacBook. I broke my computer, so I like literally don't even know how I'm gonna edit this together, but I'm bound and determined to figure it out because I seriously miss doing YouTube so much and I miss you guys so much. So thank you. I just wanna say thank you for sticking around for literally no reason. You have no excuse. Like, you just kinda like stuck it out with me for no reason. I love you guys. I owe you a lot. Yeah, let's get started with today's video. It's just basically gonna be like a sit down chat. Let me update you on what's going on in my life. Yeah, I don't know. This is just like a reintroduction. I'm a brand new me. I'm a whole new girl. I'm a woman, if you will now. I have a salary. I got a job. Okay, let's go. So first things first, where do I live? I currently live with my parents. I moved back home, graduated in May from Georgia College with a Bachelor of Science in middle grades education. I got a job at a middle school close to my house, and so I was like, you know what, I'm gonna move in with my parents, save some money, and that's exactly what I did. I do want to do a room tour because I have put so much money and so much work into this room, but I'm still waiting on nightstands, so once that's finished, then be looking out for that video. But yeah, so I live in Cleveland, Georgia with my parents and my 7th grade brother. Riley actually went off and is at UGA. She's a freshman this year, so it's just me and my parents and my little brother Jonathan. I still keep in touch with my college friends. We see each other a lot. I try to do like as many weekends with them as possible, but you know, as you grow up, things are just different and life is just crazy. But all of my people are still very much my people. I love you guys and I miss you guys, and trust me, I wish we could live in our 9-person house for the rest of our lives. That was so much fun. The last semester of college was like the best time of my life. A lot of people thought that, you know, COVID ruined it and it took away their graduation, but quarantine actually gave me so much, and I'm so thankful for that. You'll see I'm gonna put pictures and videos from that time up on the screen. It was seriously one of the most sweet and intentional and like just quality time filled moments of my life. I survived our first COVID quarantine. I'm 23, never been in a serious relationship, but I have survived quarantine. So that's an accomplishment. I'll write that on my resume. So yeah, that I'm at home. I teach full time. Speaking of jobs, I am a middle school teacher, 7th grade ELA, and I am a virtual teacher. So I kind of went into this school year knowing that things were going to be different. I was going to have to be flexible, and life was just going to be weird because, you know, when you live in a time with a global pandemic, which I know pandemic means global worldwide, so that's like double. Anyways, life just throws things at you. So 3 weeks into school, I was told I would be switching to being a full-time virtual teacher, and I've been doing just that. It's actually been a lot of fun. It's been so much hard work, but it has been worth every minute of it. I've grown so much. I've learned so much about education that I could have never in the classroom. So I live at home. I'm a teacher. Oh, I bought a car. I bought a Jeep. I bought a 2013 white Jeep Wrangler from a lot in Cleveland where I live. I saw it and immediately knew that I wanted it. I have like always wanted a Jeep since I was literally 16 years old, but when I went into the car shopping process, I was like, I'm gonna get a Toyota RAV4 hybrid. I'm gonna get the least gas mileage possible. The least, like, you know, the most gas for your mileage. However you say that, so that I can save money. I'm gonna, you know, make a good payment. And then I saw the Jeep and all my plans changed. It is white hardtop, lifted, has the big wheels, has the black tires, the black accessories, has the LED lights, has literally everything I've always dreamed of. And it was a really good price. I like got a really good deal on it. I'll put some pictures in here. I love it so much. And yeah, I'm just proud of myself. I mean, that's like such an adult decision when you finally decide, okay, I'm gonna sign my name on a contract and I'm gonna take out a loan and I'm gonna buy a car. That's like the moment you really realize, like, oh, I'm an adult and like, I'm like legally bound to something. So, I mean, obviously my job as well, but I don't know, like something about like having a loan is just so, it feels so much more grown up. So yeah, I love my Jeep. I like actually can't wait for it to be summertime because I just want to take the top off so bad, but it's so cold here in Cleveland. Like I literally can't, and it rains. It's been raining like every day this winter. So yeah, I have a new car. I have a dog. And it's a golden retriever. It's a she. So she, her name's Malibu. And I kind of like wish I had started or like been on YouTube more when I first got her so y'all could watch her grow. But she's the most precious thing in the entire world. She is a little over 9 months old and I'll go get her. She's like chef's kiss, the most beautiful thing you've ever seen. And she's so cuddly and she just loves me. We're like soulmates. She sleeps with me every night. So yeah, I'll go grab her and bring her really fast because she's so cute. I want you guys to see her. So this is Malibu. She's so big. Hi. She's such a big girl. She is the sweetest little angel baby. She loves Jonathan so much. And she sleeps and cuddles with mom every night. She's so heavy. She's getting so big. But yeah, she's the best thing. Anyways, I just love her so much. I'm literally out of breath from picking her up. She's so heavy, but like, she's so cute. You can ask anyone. I've wanted a golden retriever for as long as I can remember. Like when I graduated high school, I was like, Grandma, I know you always give us presents for graduation, so I want a golden retriever. And she was like, no, you're about to go to college. You're gonna live in a dorm. No, absolutely not. But 4 years from now, let's try it again. So that's exactly what happened. Graduated. I spent that quarantine time, like before it got really bad, I kind of was searching for dogs and found one. I found a breeder in South Georgia, connected with her, went down, picked Malibu out. And then 6 weeks later, I brought her home and she's been the most perfect angel baby ever since. I like love her so much. So yeah, I mean, I don't know what else to say. I got a dog. I'm a mom. You know that TikTok song? It's like, I'm a mother. I can't say the first part, but that's how I feel. So that's really all that's new in my life. I very much like, yes, I'm in a new place. Yes, I'm living at home. Yes, I'm working a full-time job. Yes, I have a new car and I have a new dog, but like the same values I still hold so true to me. And like YouTube, I love it so much and I miss it so much. It's been so hard. Like my camera's being weird for some reason, like won't save anything I tape on it, and my computer's been broken, and just their transition of like, okay, I was a college student but now I'm a professional. How do I balance like YouTube with being a professional and all of that? It was just so hard for me to figure out, and I kind of just got to the point where I'm like, you have to do what makes you happy. And like, yes, I will have to filter a lot of my life for my YouTube content because I am a teacher, but like it's so modernized, and like the world we live in today is so different than it was 40 years ago. And so it's okay if like I want to share my life on YouTube, and like it's okay if I want to document like me growing up as a young adult and being in this like weird stage where I'm not in college but I don't have a family, because I feel like there's so many people my age who just like need an outlet to talk to. And so most people I watch on YouTube, whether they're the same age as me or not, they're very much in the same life. pointed to me, like, they're not a student, but, like, at the same time, like, they're not married. And, you know, we always learn so much. Like, we're always told, like, you're going to graduate high school, and then you're going to go to college, and you're going to go to college, and you're going to be in a sorority, and you're going to do this. And we plan our lives forever and ever and ever. But then we skip a whole bunch, and we plan our wedding, and we plan our children, and we plan falling in love. But, like, what about the in-between? No one ever tells you how to live life between graduating college and being married. Like, there's a gap where, like, we don't prepare for our lives. And so I feel like I'm living in this transition stage of, like, I don't know what to do. So that's why I'm like, I have to get back on YouTube, because I know there's other people who feel the same way as me, and I would, like, love to be an outlet for them, and in return have a community with people like that. If you're in the same stage of life as me, please reach out. Like, message me on Instagram, message me on Facebook, on Twitter, on YouTube, comment, whatever you want to do. Like, I just, like, would love to have community with you guys and, like, be in the same stage of life, because I feel like it's so much easier to understand someone when, like, you experience it as well. So that's my soapbox. I don't know what's next for me. I mean, I'm gonna continue to push out YouTube content, not maybe as regularly as I'd hoped because my MacBook's broken, but I am gonna post. I'll probably be on my Instagram stories a lot and on my Instagram live, just because it's easier. But, like, I want to be here, and I don't know, I just love talking to you guys. YouTube feels like home to me, always has, so that's why I'm here. If you have any suggestions for, like, content I should make, or, like, things I should do, comment below. Give this video a thumbs up if you missed me, because I missed you. Follow me on Instagram and Snapchat and all the fun things. And yeah, so I'll see you guys when I see you. Bye.